We are on campus at the University of Illinois at Champaign-Urbana, talking with economist Dr. Jeffrey Hewings, director of the Regional Economics Applications Laboratory. What are some positive factors that will help the housing market going forward?
New home starts are at a record low. And while one would not want to champion that as something positive, I think what it is doing is giving a chance for the market to clear. And that is that the backlog of listings and the fact that a number of these listings are foreclosed, I think we would be in much worse shape if we were also entering the market with lots and lots of new properties. Now, of course, the negative effect of that is that without new home construction, a lot of jobs are lost. I mean, it's a very, very labor-intensive industry. And, of course, it has a ripple effect throughout the economy that is very, very significant. If you don't build new homes, you don't buy new appliances, you don't buy paint, you don't buy roofing materials, and so on and so forth. So we're looking at record low interest rates, and that is certainly providing a major incentive. But it's certainly, if we look at the other signal, where are some of the demand for these low interest rates coming from? What we've seen in the last few months is that rental rates have increased. And in fact, rental transactions in terms of properties containing rental units are actually increasing. It's one of the growth areas in the property market. And I think that represents an interesting dimension as to what point will people decide that with those low interest rates, it makes more sense for them to jump from a rental property into the housing market. At the moment, they're not. They're sort of staying put. They're waiting. What are they waiting for? Rates are not going to go lower.
A lot of first-time buyers come to market with the tax credit. What are some sources for future demand for the housing market?
Probably the one thing that realtors might want to look at much more carefully are people who are changing jobs. And in the recent past, the last 20 years, the average county in Illinois is somewhere between 11 and 70%, 17% of households change location. And they either moved in, or they moved out, or they moved properties within. But the moving in and out together amounted to about 11% of total households. That's likely to be more muted because of the lack of job growth, but bear in mind, still 90% of the labor force is employed, and there are still people who are getting promoted, still people who are finding new opportunities elsewhere. Sure. And finally, we're also, as a demographic, inching towards that population where by 2030, 20% of our population is going to be over 65. And interestingly enough, the current recession has had an interesting symbiotic effect on housing markets in more than one state. So a lot of retirees have not sold their homes in Illinois because they wanted some price that was a little higher than they can get right now. That's had a very, very negative effect on housing demand in places like Florida and Arizona and Nevada. And those are three states which have had some of the most significant decreases in housing sales prices and housing sales. And largely that's because the fuel for those increases that occurred in the last 10 years has come from retirees from the Midwest and Northeast. They're not leaving. And so that's a sort of a bottled up set of demand that is likely at some point to release itself.